Hi everybody, Scott here from the Introvert Power Channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about MBTI judging. And what I mean by judging is the judgmental kind. Now, what can happen when in life, before we've discovered the MBTI, is we can find people that we really admire, we can find people that really frustrate us or really irritate us, or we find ourselves feeling almost, you know, can feel angry just being around them, or other people that just, you know, it just seems really easy to be around them and so forth. And we can often just not understand why that is. It's just the way it is. Some people we get along with, some people we don't. And when we discover the MBTI and the cognitive functions, we can get some insight into the why of that. We can see, I'm frustrated. I can see why I was so frustrated with so-and-so. It was because they have this this particular cognitive function that, you know, is in my, which is one of my shadow functions, and that's why I have an issue with them. That's why I really struggle to be around them. Or there could be people that have, our inferior function could be their dominant function. And so on one hand, we find ourselves really drawn to them and sort of admire their ability to handle certain things or behave in certain ways that seem to become a harder for us to deal with. And so on one hand, the MBTI, the discovery of it, can help us to take judgment off people that we might have put onto them. Someone who was totally frustrating us. When we discover the MBTI and what their cognitive functions might be, we kind of get a sense of the why of that. And instead of the judgment of them and the frustration and the anger towards them that we may have, we can actually admire them. We can actually appreciate them because we now understand that they are just a completely different human being with a totally different set of cognitive functions that have their own gifts and abilities and talents. And so we can turn our disdain or our frustration or whatever on that we might have with people into appreciation and admiration. However, on the flip side of that, we can do the opposite. We can discover the MBTI and the cognitive functions and all of that, and then and discover our own type, and then we can find ourselves becoming judgmental towards people that we may not have been judgmental towards beforehand. And so in a sense, it's like the why, finding out the why of other people's processes can become a source of judgment. So for instance, like the intuitive and sensor a dichotomy, we may not have really been overly sensitive about that before we came across the MBTI, but once we discover that knowledge and we start to recognize people when they're, you know, okay, they're an intuitive, I can hear their sort of metaphorical language and I really resonate with that, or for a sensor, you know, talking about concrete things really resonates with another sensor. But then we could potentially develop being judgmental towards people that don't share similar cognitive functions or preferences for us. So they're a sensor, they're so shallow, those intuitives, you know, they don't ever say anything, you know, they're all over the place. There's a lot of words coming out, but there's nothing to grab onto. And so part of this video is really just to highlight the vulnerability and the danger that the knowledge of the MBTI can do. On the one hand, it can be very empowering, very inclusive, can be very helpful to understanding differences between people, but at the same time, it can then be a source of judgment towards other people. So it can be important for us in our own development, if we find ourselves judging others after we've learnt about MBTI and the different types, is to kind of examine that. You know, why am I doing that? And there could be a whole range of reasons that could be happening. It could be, just one type dealing with the opposite type. and there can be that pull and push, you know, attracted to the dominant function in the other because of our inferior function, but then also repelled by it. And we could sort of grow to sort of resent people that might, you know, have our inferior function as their dominant function. So we have experience of the world and the people in it, and then we discover the MBTI, and then that can help sort of normalize other people's behavior. So we understand the why of it, and so what was once frustrating and annoying, or we could be overly admiring, now has a reason for it based on the cognitive functions. That could happen, and so it's like, okay, now I can appreciate that person because now I understand their cognitive functions and I understand my own, and I can see why I was struggling to connect with them or to understand why they were behaving in a certain way or thinking in a certain way. So I think in some respects, the way of looking at it is that it can, the MBTI can sort of put to bed a lot of misunderstanding and judgment. However, it could also help to highlight unresolved judgment. So once we've had the experience of normalizing other people's behavior and taking judgment off, essentially, we could still be left with judgment that we need to explore. And that can lead us into looking at shadow work. You know, why is it that that person over there frustrates me so much? Why do I tend to admire these sorts of people and kind of place myself underneath them, you know, and rise them up? That can sort of shadow work can be very helpful for that. And I've made a video on my other channel, my Scott Morgan channel, called Shadow Work, which just goes into exploring what shadow is in a bit more detail and looks at ways of addressing our own shadow so that we can sort of develop more fully. If you want to have a look at that video, I'll leave a link to that video in the description. And thanks again for watching, and I look forward to seeing you again in another video.